She's lump. Okay, we can agree to that, can't we? Okay. So the Wisconsin Department of Public Instruction wants some of its white workers to wear a white wristband as a reminder about their privilege. And by privilege, they mean advantages you have because you're white. This is all part of a new creepy trend. Racial justice workshops where guilt-ridden white folk with degrees but no talent can learn about their own personal bias instead. Other suggestions for woe is me, whitey, include putting a note on your computer to remind yourself about your privilege and finding a person of color who will hold you accountable for addressing privilege. This is what passes for religion these days. Instead of confession, you kneel before the aggrieved and take your punishment. How does this help the true victims of racism? It doesn't. All it does is foster a victim's mentality and a class resentment that leads to pure hate. But that's what the white leftist radicals want. They know that the moment people of color stop caring about color, the radical white left agenda is dead. So they perpetuate the hate. To them, being born white is racist. And your parents committed a hate crime by having you. The worst part, it's a state agency pushing this crud under the guise of helping low-income families. No wonder these poor families aren't doing much better. The real hate crime is letting these creeps near them. Bob, I noticed coming in here, you are wearing a white bandage, but yes, you're not wearing a white wristband. How long have you been a racist?
Well, how can I count the days? Just on somewhat of a serious note, VISTA is the equivalent of Peace Corps, but it's domestic. It works in very poor neighborhoods.
Right.
I was in the Peace Corps, and going back that many years, we had exactly the same kind of training for a full day, not just a paper, but a full day, so that we could try to get ourselves to understand and appreciate the people we were working with and not bring in our own kind of privileged background with us as we went into these villages. Now, you may think that that's radical and
it is.
All the rest. Well, okay, but it served a purpose, I think, for us to remind us that we had to leave behind the life that we were living and try to understand the life they were living.
I think what you're talking about is probably something very noble. But don't you agree that it's changed, that the modern activist is now about white liberal guilt? Don't you?
Well, no, I don't. But I don't. I don't think that this is an example of trying to perpetuate blacks believing that there's racism, because A, there is racism. I mean, that's not going to go away because you say it's going to go away. And I think people who work in these inner cities as VISTA volunteers need to have a much better appreciation for the people and the lives that they live.
But the people who are volunteering, presumably they're volunteering because they have empathy and a caring heart, and they want to help somebody.
Yes.
Because they want to help somebody, not because they feel guilty about having been born white, brown, red, green, whatever. Mm-hmm. I was surprised that it was, I could understand the point of before you send somebody into the Peace Corps, you want to be able to understand like where that person is coming from. But this, when I found out it was the taxpayer-funded program, and also, it is like a brand.
Yeah, it is
brand. Basically, you're having to wear a scarlet letter, but it just happens to be a white bracelet.
Speaking of a brand, it's actually a marketing brand. They have these commercials or these web things with these guys with where they have written all over their face.
Oh, is that them?
Yeah, isn't that beautiful?
That's the group?
Delightful.
This is something different, though, right?
Yeah, this is also in Wisconsin, but it's all under the same kind of umbrella that white people are born inherently racist because they're privileged. Andrea, is it a better message? Hey, look, we have a black president. That's inspiring.
Even Tupac told us that we could let it go once that happened in one of his songs. there's not... Not
did,
all
did
white.
Rubio tell you that?
Yeah, Rubio told me that. not all white people are privileged either. And I do think that Bob does make a good point. But I think there's a different way about going about that. A white privilege bracelet, you'd think if they, there's sensitivity. You don't want to come into a low-income area dripping in diamonds or with a big Louis Vuitton bag. So I can see if that was their concern. But, Greg, that's not their concern. Their concern here, it seems, is to separate the world into two classes, as you pointed out in your monologue, victims and victimizers. And they do this to keep themselves relevant, their ideology alive. And this organization, I looked up because I'm wondering, how much are we spending on this?
Yeah.
$94 million went to AmeriCorps VISTA. Now, if money went to this program, I say you cut that white privilege money and reinstate the tours, use it for the military or something else.
They do remarkable things in AmeriCorps Vista. And I will say this, we should be a little careful here. All people who are privileged, a very small percentage of them may be racist. I don't think many of them are at all.
So then why teach it?
No, it's not a question of teaching about racism. It is question of teaching about acculturation.
That's what they do.
It was just like this morning in South Carolina, a story comes out of South Carolina that decided not to do the Medicaid expansion. And the website put out a big news story that said the reason that South Carolina denied the Medicaid expansion is because they wanted to do something bad to President Obama because he is black. I had to read it three times. I couldn't believe that this was actually being said and it
crazy.
Was serious. But a lot of people, friends of mine, were putting this out there and retweeting it and trying to get it some legs. I hope that it just dies on
the line. Don't you think it's weird, though, if someone that they're helping looks at their arm and says, why are you wearing a white bracelet? And they say, oh, it's a white privilege bracelet remind me that I've been privileged
aren't. I don't buy into the white bracelet. We didn't have to do that.
Just had sorority sweatshirts before. That was enough.
A very quick point. We got to go. I get it. But look at the people at this table. We're all white. And as far as I know, no one came from a privileged background. It has nothing to do with race. It has to do with how much hard work you're willing to do and how much sacrifice you're willing to put in.
My dad was the king of Sweden.
I couldn't agree with you more.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, I keep that. I don't like to tell people that.
Did he wear that sweater?
Yes, he did. In fact, he invented sweaters.
That's half the Swedish colors,
by the way. All your clothes are hand-me-down?
My dad invented the V-neck sweater, I'll have you know.
Oh.
And you know what? It's disgusting that you would make fun of that.
Prince Greg.
Yes. All right, we have to go. We didn't get to the other side.